Hello, good morning. I'm Manuel Castro. I'm one of the organizers of this webinar for the IOE-EQ Internet of Energy Education and Qualification Erasmus European Project. This session will be recorded and we'll put later on in the webinar side of the project, and we'll send you the recording place there. It's a real pleasure to present you Rafael Jiménez Castalleda for the University of Cádiz in Cádiz, Spain. And he will talk about the photovoltaic self-consumption grid connected as decentralized generation strategy. We have two thanks too, to the IEEE Spanish section and to the IEEE chapter of the Education Society for the support and for the dissemination of this activity, as well as other different projects that we are collaborating with. Please turn off the micros. Please, all of the people, turn off the micros and turn off the video cameras to avoid and to save some bandwidth. Thank you very much. And Rafa, you can go.
Thank you very much, Manolo. Thank you for the invitation to participate in this initiative and begin the exposition. I will try explaining some legal aspects very important in these topics, and after we will speak about the real example with a real consumer in Spain. Well, first I would like to explain the difference between the word centralized, decentralized, and distributed. These words are used in other sectors, for example, in computer, in politics world, and the meaning is different of the use of this word in the photovoltaic and energy sectors. Centralized, in general, is from one point, send the information, send the decision to a lot of the peripheral points. Decentralized, different. Minor centralized system interconnecting between them, and distributed is the more close decision and information very very close to the final users. In our case, in electric power system, when we talk about the decentralized or distributed energy generation, really We are using the same concept. I mean, when we speak about the photovoltaic decentralizing system, we speak the same decentralizing or distributed energy generation is the same. For this, in these sectors, the concepts of centralizing energy generation is this. Different great power plant distributing a lot of quantity of energy to a different consumers or areas. Decentralizing or distributed energy generation is this. Really, the generation is very very close to the users. You can see the main characteristics of centralized system mainly are grid power station sited very far from the consumption points. You need transport by the lines, electric line distribution or transmission line, a lot of energy from the power station generation to the consume areas. Really, this system requires, of course, a lot of very important electric power lines to transport and distribute all the energy to the great distance. This is very important and critical in large countries in the world because they need a lot of kilometers of very, very, very big in electrical infrastructures. For this, high energy losses in the transport and distribution power grids is produced. More or less until 10 or 15% of the total power generated are energy losses in the grid. to social and environmental problems when the electric infrastructure are built. It's a very, very difficult build some lines in some countries or areas because it is the impact over the landscape or the touristic activities maybe very important. Normally, in this system, centralized system, the primary energy used is not renewable. Logical is a not very good situation because the consequences are very severe with environmental impacts. Versus the decentralized system, this is the new concept. We are walking to the new concept of the power electric system. The decentralized system has a particular characteristic too. Normally, the electric energy generation, this is a main idea, is very close with the consumption point, normally even in the same point. Reduce the overload in the electric power transmission lines, even increasing the energy consumption. Reduction of energy losses in the power electric system has a great environmental benefits, reduce greenhouse gases emission. The final cost of the energy supplied to the user is very competitive in comparison with the electric market. This point is more important in some countries because the cost of the energy from the public grid is very high. As example, Spain has a very high cost of energy and other countries too. In this situation, the competitive of the concept of decentralized system is very nice. Normally, the primary energy used is renewable energy, specialized photovoltaics in this moment. We can see a vision of the what is the evolution of the power electric system. We can see in the picture, in the past, more or less in the past, because in some areas in the world, the system are the same nowadays. In the past, the power grid are very few system for control and coordination. Normally, by telephone or data dedicated lines to control over the some points in the distribution grid power. Only a few great plants to produce energy, and we need a lot of power line transmission lines to transport the energy from the power generation station to the consumer. And finally, the different consumer, industrial, commercial, residential. These consumers has not any possibility of energy management, only demand from the grid when they use energy, and they cannot more options. Energy from the grid, energy is consumed in their installation, but they cannot management any possibilities of energy, no storage, no self-production. This is the past. The second step is this, in the present. In the present, we have different options. Now in the grid power, we have a lot of power plant with renewable energy, with different sides of power, but all system is interconnected with a system data control based in computers with more or less smart system, more or less. In some customer, we can find some cases with a little PV or wind power installation to do some energy management. But what is the future? The future, of course, is the concept of a smart grid. I mean, we can use together lines for energy transport and use the same lines or other vehicles to transport and transmission data. We have a lot of possibility of control, different distribution control center, transmission control center, and we can use different energy services provider. And in the residential, commercial, and industrial customer, we can have a possibility for self-generation, for self-consumption, and use different energy storage, a large scale or small scale. A lot of different possibilities we can have to energy management in all the grid, because we can do my own energy in my house, for example, and only buy to the grid the difference between my consumption and my production. This is the future, very near future, because in some part of the world we have today a smart grid in operation. In Spain we have different areas with pilot projects using nowadays smart grid conceptions. Well, for apply the self consumptions and this new context of management of the power system, we need to have a liberalization of the energy sectors. This is a requirement, because it's not as impossible apply the concepts of self-consumption with renewable energy or energy storage and all concepts that today we will speak in this webinar. When we speak electric energy market liberalization, this means the main activities must be separated, because the generation, transmission, distribution, commercialization, and consumers must be different person, legal or physical person, normally legal person. The consumer can buy the energy in the free market, multiple sellers, without regulated price of the electric energy. I mean, this means in the free market, the offers and demand are the main factor to define the prices to sell in retail consumer. The consumer can do local energy management, consume, storage, self-consumption. If the system is not liberalization, is not free, and is operated under the regularization of the government, apply the self-consumption on other possibility is very, very complicated. In this frame, each consumer can have a new role. The new role means producer and consumer for the same person, defining the new word prosumer. Prosumer is a new word related with the same person to producer and consumer energy. In this picture you can see what is the operation of the free market in the energy in the sectors. We can have a different power extraction for generation, and this is the way of the energy. Is more simple, because from generation station by power line transmission, power line distribution, until the final users as consumers, final consumers of the energy. This is very simple way, but the way of the money is very, very complicated, because in a free market, the generation station, the generators must sell the energy to the pool, to the market. They can sell the energy to the pool or to the commercialization company, and the commercialization company can sell the energy to the final user. The final user cannot buy the energy to the generation, only can buy the energy by the commercialization. We can see this is the flux of the money, or the flux of money, and the flux of money from the market to the users. The users can do now producer as a small producer, and the energy is necessary management into the market by the commercialization, the commercializing. Well, in this frame, in the electric energy market, liberalization, free market, this let use a lot of kind of energy, and this energy are operating in competence, in free competence in the market. In this picture, we can show the situation more or less nowadays, because the electric generation in some years ago in the world show what is the very high dependence of the non-renewable energies. In the context of the all the world, only 25% has the origin in renewable sources. If we see the data, nowadays data in European Union, the situation is a few better, but not very, very, very best that in comparison with the old situation in the world. You can see here the non-renewable energy has a percentage very close to 66%. It's very high nowadays. In USA, the situation is worse than the all the world about the renewable energy uses. You can see natural gas, coal, and nuclear energy. If we can add the three sources, the total energy non-renewable origin is very close to 82-83%. It's a very high percentage, and we need change this model of the mix, the energy mix in each country and each the world, in all the world, to change this energy mix to more penetration of renewable energies. Well, what is the forecast PV growth market? In this picture, we can see a very interesting market for PV technologies. We can see, in comparison with other renewable energies, now the clear winner is the PV technology. In all the world, this is the main case in comparison with onshore wind, high power, offshore wind, bioenergy, etc. Only the solar power has this forecast of growth in the next year until 2024 year. Sorry, I need some water. Well, if analyzed into the PV market, what is the forecast for distributed solar PV, very important for self-consumption. In the same period, we can see the growth of the the PV in distributed uses, mainly of China, of United States and European Union, and Asia. I need, sorry, one moment. Well, this means in these countries and in the in all the world, we can see, we can wait a very, very high and very strong growing, and a lot of new application can appear in the next years. This is very interesting for the business and for the sectors, economical sector in PV market with distributed solar PV application. Well, so some concepts must be explained. The mainly concepts to understand what is the characteristics of PV self-consumptions are these. Instant self-consumption means in each instant of time, the energy between energy generated and consumption is in the same moment, is compensated in the same moment. If in this situation we have some surplus generation, this surplus generation is injected to the grid, normally without any compensation. It's a gift for the grid. This situation was the normal in Spain, but in the last year was changed totally our legal frame. Now it's different. Other possibility in this kind of instance of consumption is install a device to don't let energy surplus to the grid. Now this is the situation in Spain. If we want to do self-consumptions without surplus, we need install, it's mandatory now, install a device to don't let any energy surplus to the grid. Other concept, net metering, international concept, global concept in self-consumption, this means the surplus generation of energy power PV generated over the consumptions can be compensated kilowatt hour per kilowatt hour to get really a reduction in the energy consumption, and of course in the final billing of the energy at the final of the period. Other concepts, maybe net billing, the surplus generation of energy PV generated over the consumption, in this case, can be sold or compensated, but this compensation is in credit in monetary value. This is a discount, is applied as discount in the energy invoice. It is similar to the net metering. The difference is in net metering, the compensation is energy by energy, and in net billing is money to money. In this picture, you can see the different schemes, energy surplus sell from energy market, the energy go to the electric sellers, the electric sellers sell the energy to the consumer. The same consumer has two roles in this scheme, consumer and producer. As producer can sell the energy to the market agent, and the market agent has the responsibility of the management of this energy to send to the market. The consumer and producer has the responsibility of a consumer and the responsibility of producers. In the second scheme, this is the typical scheme applied when energy surplus compensation is the scheme selected. Energy to energy or money to money. from the electric market and by market agent energy compensation can buy to the market or send to the market the energy flux. And this agent is the responsible of the compensation of the energy, surplus energy, and supply the energy demanded by the producer consumer. This is the prosumer, we call it at the beginning of the webinar. Well, other concept very important is the grid parity. Grid parity is the point where the analyzed alternative energy source, in this case we are speak about the PV technology, in this point is possible generate electricity with a levelized cost equal to the end consumer retail price. I mean from this point to the right is more cheaper use photovoltaic energy than buy energy to the grid. Normally the cost of the grid from the energy from the grid, sorry, is each year more high and more high. This point is critical because from this point the competitive of the PV is clear. You can see as a reference what is the advance of the grid parity in the world. You can see a lot of countries, and you can see what is the level of grid parity obtained. Well, other contexts. Is the same, my question, is the same self-consumption or self-sufficiency? Clearly, no, is the same. When we talk about the self-consumption, we are talking about the energy use from the PV installation on site, and this installation is consumed for the consumer inside. But the concept of self-sufficiency is different because we can use energy from self-consumption but be impossible my self-sufficiency, because normally the needs of the consumer are in different timetable that the energy producer for the PV installation. The ideal situation to do self-consumption is when the coincidence of the PV daily production, our liquid, is the same or very, very close to the daily consume hourly profile. We can see in the picture, in a specific day, from the 0 hours until the final of the day, 24 hours. Of course, in this time, we have not solar resource and we have not electricity energy from the PV installation. You can see this is a typical cure of energy photovoltaic production in a cloudy day, not cloudy day, in a cloudy day is a more convenient situation. You can see in this installation that in this area are produced the self consumption directly, instant consumption. This is an instant consumption. All energy in this area are used for the consumer. But if the installation is more big than the requirement in these hours, this is a energy produced from the installation but not used in or by the consumers. Now this is a quantity of energy injected. This is a grid injection, energy grid injection. This is surplus energy And in this case, we can see in the same day, the energy balance has grid consumption from the grid in this period and in other this period. In this period, the energy is self-consumption, and in this point, this is in the same time self-consumption and surplus energy to the grid. This is a normal situation. The synchronization between this curve and this curve is very important to do a high efficiency self-consumption process. In this sample, you can see a typical situation for residential consumers in the top of the picture and in the commercial consumers. For example, for the same consumption, this is the value here and here, you can see the consumer need buy a lot of energy from the grid in blue color. This is the energy brought from the grid. In this case, use a very small installation. Very small installation, in this case, 0.13 kilowatts of power, of PV power. Of course, the energy produced is very small. It's a few energy in comparison with the requirement of the consumer. 100% is for self-consumption because the requirement of the energy are very high. But with a 100% of self-consumption, we have only 4% of self-sufficiency because a lot of energy is demanded from the grid. If with the same consumers, we install a big PV installation, now with 3 kilowatts of power, the situation is totally different. Now the generation, a lot of energy generated by the PV installation, is a generation surplus, is a surplus energy injected to the grid. Only of the total generation, 37% is for self-use or self-consumption. The balance of energy from the consumption point of view is this, in blue color. Now, the energy from the grid is less than the before cases, but the energy is less, but not in the same percentage of the increased generation. And now the self-sufficiency is only 35%. This means it's very important design the PV installation for self-consumption. Not is a good idea always increase the power, only the power, because if the synchronization between production and consumption is not very good, we will have a lot of energy surplus, and this is a not very convenient position, because the energy surplus to the grid, we can obtain less price than the energy buyed to the grid. For other profile of consumption, in this case, we have a very high power for self-consumption, in this case 120 kilowatts of power of the installation. In this case, mainly a very high percentage is for self-use, 94%, and only a few quantity of energy is generation surplus. Because the profile of the consumers is more similar to the production queues. Now we can see a lot of energy for self-consumption, but only near of 30% sufficiency. The other energy the consumer need buy to the grid. Well, what is the frame in the world, and what is the possibility of different regulations? We can find in each country different regulations to promote or not promote the PV self-consumption. It's clear the PV self-consumption has the objective use the electric energy generated to reduce the electric invoice. This is the general objective for all the world. First, we can obtain the reduction in the invoice, it's logical, energy by reduction, because if I produce some quantity of energy for my requirement, I need less energy from the wind. And the second step, we can have a discount from monetary value of possible energy surplus. This situation can be very different in different countries, because depend of the electric contract done and depend of the legal frame. In this picture, we can see the normal situation, more common normal situation in the world, and different parameters can be very different in the different countries. The first, have I a right to self-consume? This is the first question, because if we need the self-consumption is legally permitted, allowed or not, depending on the country. The saving on the variable price of electricity from the grid, this is the main revenues for self-consumption electricity. It's normal in all the countries. In a lot of countries, we can have different charges to finance the transport and distribution cost in the system. In Spain, these charges are now the same of the consumer without self-consumption or consumer with self-consumption. In the past regulation in Spain, we had some specific tax. These specific tax are an obstacle to spread the implementation of self-consumption. Now the situation in Spain is much more better than the last year. About the what is the process to management the excess of PV electricity? We can have net metering for compensation credit in energy. We can have net billing, monetary compensation credit in monetary unit. What is the maximum time frame for compensation? Self-consumption in real time, for example, 15 minutes, self-consumption with net metering or net billing. With this possibility, we have a different period to do the compensation, and we normally are used the real and instant value. Normally in Spain and in the majority of the country, the compensation is 1 hour, 2 hours until a period to do the billing. In Spain, we have only 1 month the time for compensation. Well, now I would like to do a checklist, comment quickly a checklist, because the time go very, very, very speed. And this is the typical checklist to analyze what is the situation in each country. You can see different aspects, PV cell consumption, what is the management of the excess of the PV electricity, other characteristics of the system. Very quickly. Right to self-consume, we can have or we can have not the permission. This is the first question. If we have not, then the history is end. Normally, in all the world, we have some possibility to do self-consumption with more or less opportunity to reduce our invoice. What is the revenues from self-consumed PV? What are the benefits can be obtained? In some countries, in some areas, we can have fiscal benefits, green certificates, or others. This is very important to do a complex economical study. Charge to finance transport and distribution grid. In some countries, we need to pay a specific tax for financing the grids. This is a problem. Now in Spain, we have not specific taxes, only the common taxes with the old people. About the excess of the PV electricity generated, we can have a possibility of a recovery by the energy surplus to the grid, selling or compensating. What is the maximum time frame from compensation? This is the compensation about the period to apply the compensation scheme, maybe daily, monthly, yearly, indefinitely, etc. What is the geographical compensation? This let use the same installation for different consumers. For example, virtual net meeting, like this, meter aggregation, this, or peer-to-peer. Depending on the regulation, in each country we can use one of them or all possibilities to apply the geographical compensation, energy compensation. The other point to end the study of this checklist, point 7, regulatory scheme duration. We have limit or not to apply the specific scheme for self-consumption. How many years to recover the investment? Normally, it's not in all countries, but normally it's a limited period. You can receive compensation for all life cycle of the installation. About the if third part ownership accepted, depend of the regulation, is possible or not. Well, about the grid codes and additional taxes, according of our before comment about the tax, we can have other taxes related with the phase balance, frequency-based power reduction, reactive power control, different concepts used for the electric company to apply other taxes and fees for the use of self-consumption in my installation. We can have other enabling of self-consumption. Yes, we can depend of the country use other instrument to help and give support to the develop of the self-consumption. You can see in this explanation some possibilities about the limit of the size. What is the size limit for the PV installation? In some countries has a limit, in other no. in Spain now we have not limit. In the past year we have a limit, but now we have no limit in the size of the installation. Well, what is the limit of electricity penetration from self-consumption in the system? If it's possible, some country we there have a limit or not? This is a question to solve. And we can other additional feature to give support to the self-consumption system. Well, with this list, we can in each country have a very good vision, the situation and the possibility to go ahead with the self-consumption application. Well, in Spain, as example, we have two possibilities. We can have a self-consumption without surpluses, and as I commented before, in this case, it's mandatory install an anti-surplus system. In this case, the user has only the consideration of a consumer and must be the PV installation owner. The second kind of the self-consumption in Spain is called self-consumption with surpluses. In this installation, can inject surplus into the grid. The user could be prosumer. If the consumer and owner of the installation is the same. Okay. Well, in this kind of self-consumption, we can have two subdivisions. First, self-consumption with surpluses with compensation mechanism. This is the situation. We can apply this simplex process to obtain a discount. Okay. The self-consumption with sole surpluses is the other possibilities. Now in Spain, the individual self-consumption and collective geographical compensation is allowed. We can have an individual or collective. Only our limit is the maximum distance less than 500 meters between the consumers and the installation. For example, in a building, we can have only one installation and use for give energy to the all neighbor in the same building. This is only the limit. Well, the connection and access to the grid need permission only when the installation has power more than PV installation, of course, more than 15 kilowatts, or for collective self-consumption installation. In other cases, and now is not necessary the permission for the PV installation for self-consumption uses. The consumer and the owner of the PV installation can be different person, natural or legal. And now too is allowed use the storage system because the use of the battery is very nice in self-consumption when the production curve are very different of the load curve. This is a typical scheme of the battery connection in the system. Well, finally, as resume of the regulation in Spain, we compare the derogate regulation, very strong and very bad for the self-consumption, and now the new regulation from the end of the past year is operative. You can see the great difference between the before situation and the nowadays situation. You can see, for example, the solar tax with the before regulation in Spain, we had a solar tax. The popular name was in tax to the sun, but now we have not any specific taxes or fees for the use or not the self-consumption installation. You can see with more tranquility the comparison between before and now the nowadays regulation frame. Well, configuration, more typical configuration. Individual consumer without batteries, this is the typical configuration. The PV panels, the inverter, maybe one or two, not three, one or two counter meter or energy meter, the charge, the loads, and the connection with the grid. This is the typical concepts. When we use batteries, this is the typical concept too. We can use a specific inverters with a possibility of connect a battery to management the battery, or use batteries directly to the particular grid of the consumer. But the unit limit is use the same counters for the photovoltaics and the solar battery. In the case of the collective consumer, we can see different possibilities in buildings, this and this, to install the system and use the energy in all the consumers. About engineering, very speed in engineering now. The simple electric concept is this: a lot, PV system, inverters and meters, balance of energy, and this is the bidirectional meter to register the energy to the grid and energy from the grid. If I use a battery, this is the simple scheme, very simple tool. The main elements, of course, the panels, mainly crystalline silicon, mono and polycrystalline, is normal because it's the market, is the major quantity. The inverters, a lot of offers in the market, and now we have a lot of manufacturers for battery storage system. About the PV array, we use normally, all engineering use normally computer aided design or computer engineering to define and design correctly the array and select what is the connection in serial in parallel to adapt the array PV of the inverter usage, because the output values of the panels, the array panel, must be correct to use the inverter selected. You can see a lot of kind of inverters and analyze the data sheet, because we need to use a correct inverters according of the output values of the PV array. The output value of PV array and input value of inverter can be coordinated. If not, the installation cannot operate correctly. We can use different configuration of inverters and arrays. Central inverters, only one inverter with a lot of panel connected to only one. Parallel inverters use different inverters with a small arrays. Normally is useful for example, different orientation in the same installation. Configuration of master slave inverter, we can use this configuration to use in the maximum efficiency point each step of inverters according of the level of the irradiance over the array panels. other configuration. This is a string inverters, one inverter only for one string, and the limit is a one inverter of each panel. This is called as micro inverters. Well, the problem of the decision with battery or without. This is the situation of the production, curve of production, and curve of demand, load curve of the consumers. We need very good information of what is the profile of the consumer to take a decision correctly. You can see in this picture the problem when the synchronization is not very good. We have a lot of demand here and here, and only the self-consumption directly is only in the in this period. But if the installation, PV installation, is very high, the problem is a lot of surplus to the grid. This surplus can produce benefits, but the value of this surplus to the grid is less than the value from the grid when I buy energy. The solution, if I install a storage system, we can convert this situation in other situation more interesting, because we can supply directly energy in the period without solar energy, thanks to the battery. Now the situation let no surplus or reduce a lot the energy surpluses, reducing the size of the installation, because if the installation is very high, is very large, already very big, I can produce a lot of energy without any benefits for the consumer. With more detail, you can see the situation in a typical day. This is the queue of production for the PV installation. We have, in the same time, power for the load. This is the requirement of the consumer. In this point, we can supply power from the PV self-consumption installation to the consumers, and use the excess of the production to battery charging process. And when the battery is totally charged, the excess go to the grid. This is the new surplus energy, the energy surplus. And this is the period without solar energy in the night, but with the energy storage in the battery, we can supply in this period to the charging battery and giving a lot of energy to the user, reducing the demand of the grid from the user. Well, if I need to install a PV self-consumption without energy surplus and without battery, we need use a system to don't let any surplus to the grid. This is the regulation from Spain, but the electrical scheme, the concept is very, very simple. Consume energy generator, PV energy generator. We need meter. What is the situation from the consumer and the grid? Go to the grid. If the system detects if energy flux to the grid, the system, the control system, give the order to the interrupter to open, disconnect the generation. Other possibility is the control over the generation, normally over the inverters, reducing the production to adapt the generation to the consumers to avoid any energy surplus to the grid. This is mandatory, one or two possibilities. in Spain, this mandatory is regulated by the technical instruction low voltage 40. This is the name in Spanish, law. Well, first we need know now what is the correct load cue. Normally, the best, the profile of 1 year, hour, 2 hour of the consume of the our consumer. Attention, we need 8,760 hours in 1 year. You can see from the our simulator, monthly load in January, daily load in January, and 1 day of January is this. This is the cure hour, 2 hour to all the year. This is the profile of a real domestic user. With this profile, we can design the installation testing different configuration. You can see the same yearly energy required for the user, and if you can see the system, the proposal system, small, medium, and large for the same consumer, you can see, sorry, lose the you can see here with this installation, the user from the grid, you see energy from the grid, energy from solar installation, and this is a surplus. If we install without battery much more power, the situation is not very, very best, because the user from solar is only a few more, but the surplus to the grid is a lot. If the installation has more size, more big, you can see a lot of energy surplus, but the energy from the user from solar is mainly the same. This means the energy surplus maybe a lot, and we can have a oversized installation for the situation of the consumer. Well, this is very important to adjust the design of the installation to the requirement, the real requirement of the user. You can see the problem here. In these graphics, you can see the for one week, you see, are real data. The energy production, this is a cloudy day, for a 1 kilowatt installation, and in green color, you can see the energy supplied to the user. Part of this energy from the sun here, but other like this, from the grid. In this picture, you can see the non-synchronization between cube producer and cube load from the user. If I change the solution from 1 kilowatt to 5 kilowatt, the problem is more big, because the energy requirement, of course, are the same in the same days, but the energy production is a lot more, producing a great energy surplus and energy for the grid. This is the situation. This is a very big problem. This is a problem. Well, we can analyze the situation with 1 kilowatt without battery, only for 3 days, and with battery. You can see the cure. I need to disconnect this bar. Sorry. Well.
I cannot find. Well. Well, I continue for I have a few times. Well, the most important in this picture, see the curve of energy requirement and the curve of energy for injected to the grid. This and this is a surplus energy. But if install a battery, I can give the best solution because only I can use the energy surplus to supply more energy to the user in these days. In other days, the energy required from the grid is less, of course, for the action of the battery. Well, in the other graphics you can see in the presentation 5 kilowatts without battery, the problem, as I spoke before, is more big. When install a grid battery, I can delete all requirement from the grid, and only I can have excess over the total requirement of the consumer covered. This is a excess over the limit useful. This energy is a gift for the system and is a oversizes. This is the proof oversize of the system over the real requirement for the consumers. This is a real economical study. Sorry, I can have I need see the top of the invoice. One moment. This is the example of the invoice. This is without battery and without self-consumption. The value of the invoice, 75 euros, real data. I repeat. And when I use self-consumption, the invoice has this value, 13. But you can see here the value of the surplus, the excess of photovoltaic production, 20 euros, but only I can apply this value because according on the Spanish regulation, the maximum value applied to apply discount of the excess of the production is the as maximum the value of the new energy consumption. You can see we have an excess of the production. If I use a battery, the situation is different. This is the invoice without self-consumption, the same of course, but now when use battery I can use more excellent of photovoltaic production and give more energy to the user. The needs of the user from the grid is very very low now because a lot of energy is supplied from the battery. Now the cost of the invoice is very low. You can compare without self-consumption and using self-consumption and batteries. Well,
in the next slide, you can see the lithium for all year. Without battery, 284 in total in the year. With battery, with the same installation, with the same consumer, 342. This is the result using battery or not. Well, in this slide, I can show the lithium of the cell consumption. Each month, you can see the benefits of use batteries because some of energy is used as cell consumption, reduction the cost of the energy, the invoice of the cost of the energy in each month. Well, as conclusion, when must be used storage system in the PV cell consumption? Of course, if the synchronization is very bad between PV generation queue versus user load queue, is interesting sync in batteries. Other question. It is important the legal frame and local regulation for the PV self-consumption spread. Of course, it's critical. If we have a non-comfortable regulation, we can have a great obstacle to develop this strategy. It is easy, the economical calculation, to define the money saving forecast? Of course not. It's complicated because I need the curve of the consumer hour to hour, and now what is the cost of energy agreed in between the consumer and the sellers? What is the value for the energy surplus? And we need to organize all the information to determine what is the real discount in the invoice. And the premium question: is profitable the PV self consumption for user? Definitely, of course, yes, of course. Well, and now thank you for your attention. And if you want any question or comments.
Thank you very much, Rafa. Thank you very much, Rafa. Really interesting, a little bit long than expected, but really, really good. We have one hand from Arun Jyoti. If you have some questions, you can unmute the micro and do it. Or anyone has some questions there?
I don't know if it's good or not.
I like it. In any case, I really like it. And some people, there is one consideration. If we consider, there are some people talking in the chatting. One question is: if we consider also the use of roofs for thermal panels, are still PV panels profitable as well as the thermal ones? Rafa,
sorry, can you repeat? I don't hear it good.
Yes, if you put in the roofs thermal panels together with PV, they can be comparable in profitable, or they can be much more expensive or less benefits from them.
You refer about the solar collector for heat application?
Yes, for hot water.
Well, now the situation, the PV panels and the PV application are a winner. The cost of the energy is very high in the grid, and more or less the payback time for a self-consumption installation now maybe more or less 5 years 5 years to recover the investment. In solar thermal collectors, require a lot of maintenance. This is the a cost of this kind of installation. And according of our experience, the payback time may be more or less 6-7 years, more or less. Now the cost of the panel and PV panel are very, very low. This is the success of the technology now in the world.
Okay, this is another question that is related with the return of investment. How much more or less was the return of investment? Which is the difference if you have self-consumption or you don't have, or you have, for example, in a standalone? Should be the same one in both cases?
Well, in the difference in self-consumption in a standalone application is the size of the battery. Remember, the battery in self-consumption in grid-connecting application, the size is more small because only we need battery to energy surplus management. But in the standalone application, we need a battery to give all energy requirement for the users, and we need 3-4 days for autonomy. This requirement needs a great size of the battery. The battery is a high cost element in the standalone application.
Yes, in this case we have to have in mind the long of the distribution line. You need to connect the place also on there.
The support of the grid is very important. Yes.
Yes, of course. I believe there is no more question. Or people, we have 10 or 12 different comments about the grid presentation. Thank you very much. And thank you, Rafa. Thank you for all the people connected. Thank you for your work in the University of Cádiz. And of course, thank you to the IOEQ, Internet of Energy Educational and Qualification European Program project. And of course, to IEEE in the case of the Spanish section and the Spanish chapter too. Thank you very much, and see you soon in other webinars of this one. Thank you. Bye-bye.
Gracias, Rafa. Thank you. Bye-bye.